This is video 6 on analysis with your Medmont E300 corneal topographer. Let's start by selecting a patient. We can click once on the plus sign to open up the patient file or double click the patient name. We can see we have one right topography. Let's select that topography. And with your display window open, we have a number of different analysis options that we talked about in video 5, axial, tangential, refractive, elevation, and others. When you're getting started with your Medmont, it may be recommended to use axial power as a way to interpret your corneas. Axial power is very helpful in understanding how the anterior surface of the eye may contribute to a patient's refraction and visual acuity. For instance, this patient has with the rule corneal astigmatism. We can see with simulated K readings, the flat axis is at 1 degrees and the steep meridian is at 91 degrees. We can see we have 1.4 diopters corneal sill, steep meridian running vertically, flat meridian running horizontally. This would be a with the rule corneal astigmat. We can also interpret from the axial map that this is an apical astigmatism. The figure eight or bow tie shaped astigmatism is very much central or centralized within the pupil. Compare that to this particular patient where you see against the rule corneal astigmatism of a very similar amount of corneal sill, 1.6 diopters on this against the rule eye. But again, we see centralized corneal astigmatism. Compare this apical or centralized corneal astigmatism to what's described as limbus to limbus corneal cylinder or astigmatism. In this particular case, the figure eight or bow tie is not centralized to the pupil. It very much extends from one side of the eye to the other. We can observe that this patient has with the rule corneal sill, but dissimilar to the first patient analyzed, it is not centralized. It is limbus to limbus. When you have a limbus to limbus corneal astigmat, you may want to click on the analysis and details and compare the weighted average height or the sagittal depth in the flat meridian versus the steep meridian. Notice 1587 microns on the flat, 1825 microns on the steep. There is a huge differential between the depth of the eye horizontally and the depth of the eye vertically. When fitting contact lenses, this would be profound in trying to fit this limbus to limbus 4.2 diopter corneal astigmat with a spherical GP lens. Clearly a toric would be required, both because the corneal astigmatism is high, but also because it's limbus to limbus corneal sill, and because you have a very high differential between the flat meridian and the steep meridian in depth of eye. For a keratoconic, you would see a map looking more like this, where we don't see a defined flat and steep meridian, and we don't see a bow tie shaped astigmatism. We see a typical ectasia where the steepest point of curvature is inferior of the apex. For more information on understanding diseased eyes, go to video 7 on analysis on asymmetrical and diseased eyes. This concludes video 6.